Jimmy Watson, an invigorating start for FC Dallas here at TCF Bank Stadium, infuriating for Minnesota United. What's the message from the bench at the moment?
Well, it's frustration when another goal went in the first 15 minutes, but it's really about covering Michael Barrios and getting closer to him. Their system is drastically different than Minnesota United's. They like to keep their wingers out wide and exploit the speed. So now Minnesota United is getting instructions from the bench on how to deal with that and how to make sure everyone is accounted for at all times.
He was stupendous in the goal, though, wasn't he, Jimmy Watson?
Well, Barrios is known around the league, 13 assists. He's more known for his speed, but Birch has dropped off here, and he defends, he jockeys too far deep into his own box. At some point, there has to be a line of confrontation. It's a fantastic ball across in between Foxhole and Tiasson for a tap in for Tesho, but I'd like to see Mark Birch engage quicker and a little bit sooner, because at that point, you can't dive in, and if you miss, it's a penalty. It's wonderful by Barrios, could be a little better by Birch.
Minnesota United back on level terms through Christian Ramirez.
Well, another part that wasn't noticed was Calvo right there jumping the run to steal it from Rudy. He plays it to Molino in that perfect spot. There's the pass that Christian Ramirez got himself wide open for. He opens his hip and he closes it at the last second. Jesse Gonzalez bites on the first one, and it's the second move, passes it to the corner for his 13th goal of the season. Well, Ethan Finley, a strong performance last week in your debut with Minnesota United. Apart from the result, you got the goal early on. How good was that for you, for your confidence, getting a goal early?
That's great. It's great for my personal confidence.
Yeah, you talk about having a short memory, and that's vital as a center forward. You get that moment right off the corner kick. Kevin Molino puts it in. Talk us through that play and what goes through your mind.
They fell asleep.
Where Jimmy Watson is with Adrian Heath.
Adrian, a frantic first 45, culminating your team getting an equalizer. What needs to be different in the second half to go out and get maximum points tonight?
Well, we can't start like we did the first half.
A big one tonight, a pivotal matchup against the Houston Dynamo. They like to play with three up high. That's something a little bit different than a lot of teams. How did you guys prepare for that this week, and what are you expecting tonight? Adrian, we spoke at halftime, and you had a sense of calmness about you, despite what had gone on in the first half, and it showed in your players' performance. What was your thoughts of the second half and how they rebounded after that first half?
Well, first and foremost, I think it would have been a travesty if we hadn't taken something out of the game.
Those guys are unbelievable coaches, and you've been had so much of your success with them. But, you know, over the course of your career, you've managed to score goals in a ton of different ways, but let's hear from you. What makes you so good at scoring goals?
Christian Ramirez, the goal scorer tonight in a 1-0 win against Orlando City, and you run straight to Adrian Heath. Why was that?
It's a special game for him.
Francisco Calvo, the captain, wearing the Pride armband tonight with pride, and you go and get a performance to be proud of. Tell us how you feel about tonight and the big win against Orlando City.
The champ is here!
Well, let's be honest, there's a big championship fight tonight, but Thursday, the real champion was crowned. Cal, Kendra, this is mine until next year at the State Fair. I would try to put it on, but it actually doesn't fit anymore after that. So it's just going to go over the shoulder right here.
I did notice the circumference of your mouth, actually, just before we were starting to do that. And I said to Kendra, I think we're in trouble here. And it was unbelievable. For such a small man, you put an incredible amount of food in your mouth in that amount of time as well. I mean,
what a heartwarming piece that was. Scott put that together, Brad Baker. It was an amazing, amazing time. Cal, I'm so happy I got to spend that with you. It fills my heart with happiness. There's no happiness like a special needs child. It's just raw, pure emotion. And I'm so glad we got to do that this week. That was a wonderful thing, wasn't it?
It was fantastic.
Bienvenue a Stade Saputo in beautiful Montreal, Canada, as we get set for the Montreal Impact versus Minnesota United tonight. Gorgeous night here in Montreal, what should be an enticing matchup. Speaking of enticing matchups, this week in Call Your Shot, we were able to get a guy who's got 32 goals and 32 assists in his MLS career to join us. Now, basically, what we just established is he could put the ball wherever he wants. So a lot of people thought I was crazy when I took him on. Well, we were able to get Ethan Finley to join us, and what a treat it was. Hope you enjoy this edition of Call Your Shot.
Finley had a glorious opportunity against Vancouver. They need him to take those chances here this evening.
Well, Ethan Finley is already proving his worth. He's already scored 2 goals and has 2 assists in his short time here. But when he gets moments to score and moments to take the offense by the reins, he needs to do that. There's one in particular I want to look at. As we go to the video, you've got a wonderful playmaker in Ibsen, a guy who can just create something out of nothing. His vision is incredible.
when we look at the video, we'll see exactly this wonderful run that he makes, and we'll see what Ipsen can do. He can play provider out of the periphery of his vision. He sees Ethan Finley get up behind. As Ethan Finley takes this touch, have a go. Put it on target. Go high, near post. Go across the goal. Do something different. But as he waited a second and hesitated, it really took him to the end line. His only option was to look to cut back, and nobody was able to keep up with him because it was such a good run that got him in behind. Minnesota United is going to need to get in behind. They're going to need to join Ethan Finley because he is the man who the attack has gone through. And with the addition of Christian Ramirez, certainly that'll help. Cal, Kendra, back to you.
Very good players as well, don't they?
Absolutely, and a plethora of options for Coach Carl Robinson. And putting a 16-year-old in the starting lineup, a kid that is an immense talent, as we were talking about. A couple other changes, Eric Hurtado, he's done well in MLS in his time, normally a sub, but he comes on. Look, it's one of these things. Carl Robinson has a lot of decisions to make as he gets later on into the season. Kendra mentioned they're one win away from going top of the West. So Carl Robinson, when he got to the stadium, guy I know from back in his playing days before he made the jump to the coaching side, we had a few laughs, we caught up, and I was able to get his thoughts ahead of the matchup tonight against Minnesota United. Carl Robinson, your team finds itself 3 points out of first place in the Western Conference. This is your fourth year now coaching the team. What's different about this year's team as opposed to years in past?